program verification has been important for a long time, and its importance is only increasing as we have more and more parts of our infrastructure being controlled by software.
This is Victor Kunchak, professor of the IC School at UPFL, and today I want to give you a little bit of a scare of some possibly devastating small algorithmic glitches.
And certainly, today we have a major transportation infrastructure that is controlled by software. If you think about railway, airplanes, so airplanes are controlled by control software. So there's no direct link between the controls that the pilot does and what the airplane does. Everything goes through some sort of software. And so if the software misbehaves, then there could be catastrophic failures that may result in major damage and also loss of human lives.
These days, algorithms are ubiquitous. We have become hugely dependent on algorithms, whether it is to check the news, to choose which YouTube video to watch next, or to secure financial transactions.
And so this trend is continuing with the advent of, for example, autonomous cars.
As we've discussed it with Boy Feltings, autonomous cars are coming, and they're coming fast.
We also see the other parts of infrastructure, like electrical grid that is controlled by software, and we had examples of electrical grid failure that were in part due to software errors.
In fact, the list of potentially critical computational errors just goes on and on and on. Here's a webpage that lists 20 famous software disasters of the past. In 1982, the CIA foresaw the purchase of a computer system by the Soviets. The CIA sabotaged the software in such a way that it would pass the Soviet inspection but fail in operation. This software would go on causing overpressure in a Trans-Siberian gas pipeline, thereby causing the largest man-made non-nuclear explosion in Earth's history. In 1987, an early panic movement of investors was amplified by computer trading programs, generating a flood of sell orders that made the financial systems of Wall Street crash. The losses due to this crash are estimated at $500 billion in a single day. In 1999, the UK Passport Agency introduced a new but faulty computer system, but at the same time, a new law was passed according to which children under 16 had to have a passport to travel abroad. Peaks in passport demand combined with the new faulty computer system led to millions of pounds of additional costs, along with huge queues for new passport demands. These examples are very spectacular and they have cost a lot of money, but algorithmic failures can even be a matter of life or death.
Another example is our devices that are used in for health. For example, a pacemaker is controlled by a piece of software, so a failure in that software could endanger the life of the person that is wearing the pacemaker.
And this is not merely restricted to medical devices that our body will be hosting.
Radiotherapy machines are also controlled by software, and there's a very important quantity here, which is the amount of radiation that needs to be carefully dosaged. And if this is done wrong, then this can result in overexposure to radiation, and this has in fact happened and led to a loss of human life.
And similarly, cure treatments often heavily rely on the correctness of algorithms.
So infusion pumps determine what kind of medicine is being inserted into your bloodstream, and if they misbehave, of course, there could be wrong dosage that could be fatal. And so these are examples of software that could have critical consequences, but also everything else that we rely on that manipulates information relies on infrastructure software, on the cloud infrastructure, and if some of this is misbehaving, we have outages, we have a huge loss of productivity, and maybe some of the worst possible scenarios are it's still something that we could potentially experience in the future, and that's something that we need to sort of be prepared and work to prevent.
This simple memory allocation line laid waste to $7 billion in 10 years of time.
So program verification is activity whose aim is to establish that program satisfies some desired properties.